Hello and Namaste, my name is Nidhi Nagori and welcome back to my channel. I'm still on with the CPA game, but today we're talking a different kind of a CPA. आज हम किसी और CPA की बात करते हैं. तो किस CPA की बात कर रहे हैं? आप सबने बहुत ज्यादा रिक्वेस्ट की थी इसकी, इसलिए आज हम बात करने वाले हैं CPA कनाडा की. हमारे साथ है निमिषा. निमिषा इंडिया से CA है और उन्होंने CPA कनाडा भी कंप्लीट किया है, तो वो हमें बताएंगे कि क्या एग्जैक्टली है वो MOU जिसके बारे में हम हमेशा सुनते रहते हैं, क्या है इसका प्रोसेस, कितना खर्चा लग जाता है और एग्जाम पैटर्न क्या होता है, रिजल्ट्स कब आते हैं, सारी डिटेल्स जो हैं हमें मिलेंगे निमिषा से. बिफोर मूविंग इनटू द वीडियो, डू नॉट फॉरगेट टू लाइक, शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब. मेक श्योर यू गिव दिस वीडियो अ बिग थम्स अप एंड लेट अस नो इन द कमेंट्स व्हाट इज इट दैट यू वांट टू नो अबाउट CPA कनाडा मोर, एंड आई विल डेफिनेटली कवर दैट इन वन ऑफ माई नेक्स्ट वीडियोज. On that note, let's go straight to the details of CPA Canada and help you become one.
Okay, first of all, thank you, Nidhi, for having me here. And then, hi guys, hi everybody.
All right, Nimisha, तो सबसे पहले ना आपके introduction के साथ start करते हैं कि आपका background क्या है, कहाँ से हैं आप और CPA Canada क्यों सोचा आपने?
Sure. Okay. So, hi everyone. I am Nimisha Agarwal, and I am basically from Mumbai, Maharashtra, and I am an Indian Chartered Accountant. I completed my BCom graduation in 2014, and then I completed my Chartered Accountancy in 2015. Mm-hmm. Then I started working in the corporate, and have been working since. In 2018, I applied for my. I started the process of my Canadian PR, and. By March 2019, I got my PR. I got my CO PR. So while I was applying for the PR, I had already thought of, you know, since I was supposed to come there, I was already thinking about how to take a Canadian education or a professional education, because I think every country will require its own, you know, qualification to give a job or anything. And considering that, I thought that CPA was the best option. Number one, because it matches my profession over here in India. And number two, as an Indian CA, there were a lot of exemptions in place. So that is why I thought that this will be the best option. So along with my Canadian PR, I also started researching about CPA Canada. Since I was a little hopeful that my PR application won't get stuck anywhere in the under the express entry, I started the process of registration of CPA.
Okay, so you started it side by side with your Canadian PR.
Yeah, so approximately just 1 month before receiving my CO PR, I started the process of registration. Good. Because registration takes a lot of time for the approval of registration. CPA Ontario, on their website also they have mentioned it takes about up to minimum 12 weeks. So keeping that in mind, I was already running late for the September attempt, because for the September attempt, usually May end is the last date for enrollment. And before enrollment, you need to be registered.
Wow.
So that's why, that is how everything came into place.
Okay. And, you know, this is a very common question that I get from a lot of people who are moving to Canada, that can we do US CPA? And to me, logically, it had never made sense, because if you're moving to Canada, why would you do US CPA? It just, to me, it was more of like that. Did you ever think of doing US CPA by any chance?
Yeah. Yes, I did think, actually, when I started off with this, I thought about a lot of options. Like I thought of ACCI, I even thought about CPA US, like you mentioned. But since I told you, like, I thought that it would be better to get a qualification of the country that you're going into.
I agree.
So that made a little more sense to me in terms of education also, because I will be studying the laws of the country in which it is applicable. I'm not saying that CPA US is not considered as a good qualification in Canada, but I thought for me that CPA Canada is a better choice.
Makes sense. Yes. So how does this happen when you are a CA? Now, I think a lot of people know there is an MOU. But
yes,
what really is an MOU? What benefits does it give you? क्या होता है जब you know एक MOU place में होता है? हमको as an Indian CA उससे क्या फायदा होगा? कैसे हम उस MOU को use कर सकते हैं? वो process please बताइए.
Correct. So जब मैंने चालू करा था for my CPA registration, so mine was the first year अंडर द एमओयू ऑफ आईसीएआई एंड सीपीए ऑन्टारियो, जिसके अंडर आपको कैपस्टोन वन एंड कैपस्टोन टू नहीं देना है. बेसिकली यू डोंट हैव टू अपियर फॉर कैपस्टोन वन एंड कैपस्टोन टू, यू कैन डायरेक्टली गिव द सीफी, सीएफई आप डायरेक्टली दे सकते हो. So because of that, what happened was I started the registration process. The registration process is fairly very simple. जो भी requirements है उनकी website पे बहुत ही simply दिया हुआ है. There will be no confusion regarding the documents that are required. So documentation wise, I had no confusion. I think the documentation process or the registration process right now has changed. अभी change हो गया है registration process. It has become online. Yes, अभी portal पे आ गया है. A year back, मुझे सिर्फ documents email करने थे उन्हें. There was no portal where I had to register, but the documents were all the same. जो अभी documents applicable है वो तभी भी applicable थे.
So the requirement hasn't changed.
No, the requirement as such 90% hasn't changed. Okay. There is only one requirement that has changed. I think कि अभी उन्हें WS का जो report है वो उन्हें document by document evaluation चाहिए. There is one thing called as International Credential Advantage Package, जिसके under they require a evaluation by WES, but उसके लिए भी there are two requirements. So there is one that if you have a recognized university degree and 2 years of experience, तो उसके लिए आपको वो documentation चाहिए evaluation का year by year.
Okay.
So during my time that was not applicable. जो WS report मैंने PR के लिए initiate किया था वही WS report मुझे वो time पे काम आ गया था. So this is the only requirement which everybody who's registering now will have to look into. Okay. But उसका भी उन्होंने काफी अच्छे से website पे explanation दिया है कि आपको क्या करना है उसके लिए.
So it is very clear on the website. It is self
absolutely very clear. There is a separate section for internationally trained chartered accountants on the CPA Ontario website. So it is absolutely very simple.
Okay, perfect.
उन्हें कोई दिक्कत नहीं आएगी.
Guys, if you guys are planning to do it from Ontario, Nimisha, the way she's saying, you know, हम सब समझ ही गए हैं. Please go to their website. It is very clear. सब आपको easily समझ आ जाएगा. Because CPA US बहुत clear नहीं है. तो इसीलिए कोई जब कहता है कि अरे बाबा CPA Canada easier है या clear है in terms of what they want, तो you know थोड़ा सा ऐसे लगता है कि अच्छा ये information सही है या नहीं. But आपसे पता चल रही है, आपने experience actually में you've lived the experience.
Yes, yes.
You know, okay. So that is good to know. And so इसके exams, ये documents जो है बहुत simple है, आप submit कर दो. आपने बोला कि 12 weeks लग जाते हैं. Like it takes 12 weeks.
So for me, it did not take exactly 12 weeks. So I registered on the 1st of March. I sent them the documents of 1st of March, and my registration came through on around 8th of May.
Okay.
It took more than 2 months, but they have specifically mentioned on the website that it will take up to 12 weeks minimum.
Okay.
So if we go by the letter, then you will have to wait for minimum of 12 weeks.
12 weeks. And if it doesn't happen in 12 weeks, is there like a way to reach out to them, or what if there
is? You can always email them. You can always email them.
Okay.
They are very responsive like that. You will always get a reply.
Okay. So you got this registration approval. So does that mean that you registered as a CPA Ontario student?
Yes, I registered as a CPA Ontario student who is educated outside India.
Okay, all right. And iska
outside cost, Canada, sorry.
Yeah, okay. So iska cost kitna tha kareeb? How much did it cost?
Okay, so there are two types of cost in this. The first cost is registration cost as a student. So while you are registering for CFI, there will be a specific registration cost which is incurred for them to register you as a student. So that was $819.25, something like that, including taxes.
Okay.
And the second kind of fees is after registration, after approval of your registration, that is for your exam fees, to appear for the exams. And that fees was for CFI, it was $1,500 plus taxes, which the total comes to $1,695.
Okay. So $1,695 plus your $819.
Yeah. The $819 depends upon the months you are registering in. So it is basically prorated. Oh. So Yeah. So basically, if you're registering between 1st of November to 30th of June, it's $819. And if you're registering between 1st of July to 31st of October, it is the half of it. I think it's around $480 or $490, something like that. And that is also very clearly mentioned in the list of documents and the fees and everything. Everything is mentioned on just one page on their website.
Perfect.
So
okay, so we're looking at that, and this is Canadian dollars, right?
Yes, this is
So
Canadian.
we're looking at about 2,500 Canadian
Yes.
dollars. So that happened, and then you got your enrollment in May, so early May.
Right. Yes.
Okay. And so in terms of, so what did you do after that? Like, did you have to go and look for study material so CFI, I know, so CFI is, and people don't get confused, this is not certified fraud examiner. This is CFI is CFE, of course, but usko CFI kehte hain yahan pe. This is how they pronounce it.
Common final examination, yeah.
Right. So इसमें कितने subjects हैं, या ये single subject है, scoring क्या है, scores, requirements to pass, etc. What is the pass score? क्या है, होता क्या है ये CFE?
So I'll tell you my journey because every person has a different journey. So
Absolutely.
I'll start with my journey.
Sure.
So basically, after doing the enrollment in May, I had already researched about what is the course about, what are the subjects. But the tricky part of this, the whole of this is getting notes. So जैसे हम इंडियन सीएस को आदत है कि इंडिया में यू गेट नोट्स एवरीवेयर, आपको नोट्स की कभी तकलीफ नहीं होगी, आप किसी से भी नोट्स बोरो कर सकते हैं, यू कैन गेट देम, गेट अ फोटो कॉपी एंड स्टार्ट स्टडी. सो दैट इज नॉट एप्लीकेबल देयर इन कैनेडा बिकॉज कैनेडा हैज अ लॉट, इट हैज वेरी स्ट्रिक्ट कॉपीराइट लॉज. सो दिस इज वेयर आई फेस अ लॉट ऑफ डिफिकल्टीज.
ओके
सो टिल द टाइम माई रजिस्ट्रेशन वेंट थ्रू, आई डिड नॉट हैव एक्सेस टू एनी रिसोर्सेज, आई कुड नॉट स्टार्ट एनी प्रेपरेशन. आई इवन सर्च फॉर सम थिंग्स ऑनलाइन, गूगल भी करके देखा मैंने, बट देर वॉज नथिंग दैट आई कुड फाइंड ओवर देयर. सो आई हैड टू वेट टिल माई रजिस्ट्रेशन वेंट थ्रू बिकॉज आई हैड नॉट ज्वाइन टेकन अप एनी क्लासेस और एनीथिंग लाइक दैट. वर्चुअल क्लासेस मैंने ऐसे कुछ भी ज्वाइन नहीं की थी.
ओके
फिर रजिस्ट्रेशन हुआ, उसके बाद में जब मुझे रिसोर्सेस का एक्सेस अराउंड 10 days बाद मिला उसके, तो जब मैंने कोर्स मटेरियल देखा तो कोर्स ऑफकोर्स इट इज वेरी एक्सटेंसिव. अब एक्सटेंसिव क्यों है, बिकॉज एज एन इंडियन सी आई, इफ आई कैन एक्सप्लेन दिस, इट इज बेसिकली लाइक आपको वो सीपीटी, आईपीसीसी और सीए फाइनल, वो आपको एक साथ देने के लिए बोल रहे हैं. इफ यू आर गिविंग द फाइनल एग्जाम, इट इज एज गुड एज यू आर गिविंग ऑल द थ्री लेवल्स टुगेदर.
True, true.
सो द कोर्स इज ऑफकोर्स गोइंग टू बी एक्सटेंसिव.
Yeah.
द मटेरियल वर एक्सटेंसिव एंड आई हैड ओनली टाइम टिल सेप्टेम्बर एंड ऑलरेडी हाफ ऑफ मे हैड पास्ड अवे. So I got a little panic because looking at the resources, but anyhow I still started with my preparation. And the catch over here is that you have to select one subject as your in-depth subject.
Okay.
Okay, so you have to also, you know, carefully select which subject of yours will you select as an in-depth subject. So financial reporting is one subject which is compulsory for everybody to be studied in depth.
ओके
तो वो ऐसा एक सब्जेक्ट है जो आपको इन डेप्थ स्टडी करना ही है, ठीक है. एंड सेकेंड सब्जेक्ट जो है वो आपकी चॉइस है कि आपको कौन सा चाहिए. सो उसमें ऑप्शंस थे ऑडिट, टैक्सेशन, फाइनेंस एंड परफॉर्मेंस मैनेजमेंट.
ओके
ओके सो परफॉर्मेंस मैंने सिलेक्ट किया था परफॉर्मेंस मैनेजमेंट बिकॉज आई वॉज द मोस्ट कंफर्टेबल विद इट. बिकॉज उसमें कैसा है, स्ट्रैटेजी एंड गवर्नेंस प्लस इट इज अ मिक्सचर ऑफ स्ट्रैटेजी एंड गवर्नेंस एंड कॉस्टिंग. So I
ओके
think I thought that I was the most comfortable with it. So I selected that as my in-depth study subject, and I started my preparations with the official resources which I got.
ओके
So now coming here about the resources, मुझे ये बहुत बार लोगों ने LinkedIn पे पूछा है कि आपने पढ़ाई कैसे की. So this is the most frequently asked question which people have asked me on LinkedIn also a lot of times.
या
So अभी आई विल व्हाट आई विल से इज दैट द ऑफिशियल रिसोर्सेज आर वेरी सिंपल. मतलब अगर आपके पास टाइम टाइम हो या नहीं हो, अगर आपको समझना है कोई चीज को, अगर आप स्टार्टिंग से भी चालू करेंगे, लाइक अगर आपको बहुत टाइम हो गया है पढ़ाई किए, यू वांट टू ब्रश अप योर कॉन्सेप्ट्स, तो वो बहुत, इट इज वेरी सिंपल. द लैंग्वेज इन द नोशिया मटीरियल इज वेरी सिंपल, इट्स एक्सट्रीमली सिंपल, इट्स ले मैन लैंग्वेज. सो आई फाउंड द नोशिया मटीरियल लैंग्वेज टू बी वेरी सिंपल एंड रीडेबल, एंड बहुत सारे उसमें एग्जाम्पल्स दिए हुए हैं. सो जस्ट वो बहुत एक्सटेंसिव है नो डाउट बट इट इज वेरी इजी
ओके
इज व्हाट आई वुड लाइक टू से. सो आई रेफर दोज मटेरियल एंड कमिंग टू द फैक्ट दैट हाउ द एग्जाम्स आर कंडक्टेड. सो इट इज अ 3-day एग्जाम. इट इज इनटू 3 days, डे 1, डे 2 एंड डे 3. एंड जैसे हम इंडियन सीएस को क्वेश्चन एंड आंसर फॉर्मेट में एग्जाम्स लिखने की आदत है, ये बिल्कुल भी वैसा नहीं है. द फॉर्मेट इज टोटली डिफरेंट ओवर हियर. ओके. सो सीफी का जो फॉर्मेट है दैट इज केस बेस्ड फॉर्मेट. विथ केस व्हाट आई मीन इज दैट वो आपको एक बहुत बड़ा केस देंगे एंड यू हैव टू राइट ऑन दोज लाइन्स. यहाँ पे आपको क्वेश्चन पूछा जाएगा और आपको आंसर लिखना है, वैसा नहीं है बिल्कुल भी. द फॉर्मेट इज एब्सोल्युटली डिफरेंट. बहुत ही डिफरेंट फॉर्मेट है इसका एंड आई विल से दैट इट इज अ वेरी प्रैक्टिकल फॉर्मेट.
ट्रू.
सो यस, सो इट इज अ वेरी प्रैक्टिकल फॉर्मेट एंड आई थिंक दैट दिस इज वन रीजन वेर मोस्ट इंडियन सीएस और मोस्ट ऑफ अस विल फेस अ लिटिल डिफिकल्टी. Only because of the fact that we have not given such exams or we have not been trained for such exams.
Yeah.
If you have actually completed your education in India.
True. I agree.
So this is one place that I faced a little difficulty.
Okay.
During my preparation.
Okay. And so ye, the exam was over 3 days. So was it like one, like financial reporting was in one day and then your in-depth subject on, so how does that happen, the exam over 3 days?
Okay. So since it's 3 days, I will also tell you how it is evaluated. So okay. Day one, day two and day three exams are on 3 days. Day one is evaluated separately and day two and three are evaluated separately.
Oh.
So it is like, aap day one agar clear ho gaye, तो वो अलग से इवेल्युएट होगा. अगर आप डे टू डे थ्री क्लियर नहीं भी हुए तो, अगर आप डे वन पास हो गए तो आपको नेक्स्ट अटेम्प्ट में डे वन नहीं देना पड़ेगा और डे टू एंड थ्री साथ में इवेल्युएट किया जाता है.
अच्छा. एंड इफ यू पास डे टू एंड थ्री देन
तो आपको डे टू तो डे वन नहीं वो नहीं देना, डे टू एंड थ्री नहीं देना पड़ेगा, सिर्फ डे वन देना पड़ेगा.
ओके ओके
ओके. So yeah. These are two separate evaluations that happen and day one is basically what they call as enabled competencies. So basically usme aapki communication skills jo hai wo log wo evaluate karte hain. Your writing skills and communication skills are what is evaluated. How you think, how you plan, how you strategize is what is evaluated in day one.
Okay.
And day two is basically for your in-depth subject. Jo subject aap in-depth चूज करोगे इट इज इट फोकसेस ऑन दैट. डे टू इज बेसिकली मेनली अबाउट दैट एंड एफ आर एंड इन डेप्थ सब्जेक्ट इज डे टू एंड डे थ्री में सारे सब्जेक्ट आपके इवेल्युएट किए जाते हैं.
ओ ओके.
सारे सब्जेक्ट आपके डे टू एंड थ्री में इवेल्युएट किए जाते हैं.
ओके ओके.
सो दिस इज हाउ इट वर्क्स एंड ऑन डे वन यू विल गेट वन केस एंड वो केस का जो बैकग्राउंड है वो आपको ऑलरेडी दिया जाएगा. वो आपको सीपीए ऑन्टारियो से ईमेल आ जाएगा आपके एग्जाम के पहले ही दैट दिस इज द बैकग्राउंड ऑफ द केस एंड उसके देन दे क्रिएट अ सिचुएशन लाइक दिस वाज द केस आफ्टर 5 to 10 years दिस इज द सिचुएशन नाउ. ऑन द डे ऑफ द एग्जाम यू विल गेट द सिचुएशन ऑफ 5 to 10 years व्हाट इज द सिचुएशन ऑफ द कंपनी राइट नाउ. सो दिस इज हाउ दे क्रिएट द केस. सो आपको जो बैकग्राउंड केस
कम्युनिकेशन स्किल्स like this.
Yeah, basically mainly communication skills and of course they will test you on the, but technicals will be karenge but that is not a great part of it.
Okay.
Kyunki aap likhenge to aap technical mein hi likhenge. Right. You will write about FR and stuff. Right. Only but
right.
What they will focus is on other competencies.
Okay. I see.
So yes, so this is how it will work and for day one there is a specific format also in which you have to answer. So this is something that I did not know because I did not have any guidance. I did not know how to prepare for it. So I did a lot of research. I googled. I read some answers on forums where I could get some answers. So I understood that this is how specifically day one has to be attempted. So that is also something that everybody who is doing it should, you know, yeah. read about a little and get some knowledge about it, especially if you are not joining any classes or there is nobody to guide you on one-to-one basis. So that is how day two and day three are, like I said, day two is depth subject and day three is all the subjects.
Okay. And how long are these exams for?
Basically, all the exams on all the days, they range between 3 to 4 hours.
Okay, all right. And then how much do you have to score to pass?
There is no scoring that is given. The results just come as pass or fail. So there is a rankers list. There is a rankers list that they come out with, but otherwise there is no score.
Okay, I see. So you just get a result that you've passed or failed.
Yes.
So how do you get a sense of whether you've passed or not?
I think that sense of everybody comes out very differently. It is, that thing is absolutely similar to what we do in our chartered accountancy exams.
Okay. I agree. And then, when it comes to, because this is a very different format, it's clearly, you know, very different. So all the exams are case-based or like, do you have stuff like MCQs or, like simulations or just not writing really lengthy technical answers, jo hum jaise India mein likhte hain. So any of that, or is it just like mostly case-based exams?
Nahin, teeno din jo hai, wo case-based exams hi hai. And they are lengthy. You will need to have a lot of typing practice because here you don't have to write, you have to type it. So aapko khud ka computer laptop leke jana hai, you will have the software installed. Wo software ka link aapko CPA Ontario exam ke pehle bhej deta hai. They also give you a chance to test the software. You can write a practice test on the software just to see whether it's working or not. So aapko apne typing speed pe bhi bahut kaam karna padega because yeah. No doubt, बहुत लोगों की typing speed बहुत अच्छी होती है, but exam in itself is a little lengthy process.
True.
So वहाँ पे what I will suggest or what I did was I wrote a lot of cases before appearing for my exams. That will help a lot.
Okay, and do you have any mock exams that you can give for this?
So on the CPA Ontario website. Inside the official resources, they have past 3 year papers.
Okay.
वहाँ पे certified board examiners की report है, जहाँ पे last 3 साल के papers आपको मिल सकते हैं.
Okay.
So you can download them and you can refer them.
Yeah.
And for people those who have joined a class or something like that, वो that help they will get from there.
Okay. But you did not take any classes as such, and you did
no.
not try.
So here's a there's a catch over there that. After when I started studying in May, the course was very extensive and I started studying. But then what happened was that in June or July, I realized that the course is too extensive and I have very little time. And the fact was that along with giving exams in September, I also had to do my soft landing.
Oh yes.
So yeah. So I had to prepare for that as well. All the documentation and the goods to follow list. वो सब भी मुझे बनानी थी. But so I continued with that. फिर मुझे जाके mid August में realize हो गया that even if I am very good with my technicals, it will not help me because again, like I said, it's not a question answer session.
Yeah.
I will have to figure out a way to write the cases.
Yeah. True. True.
तो वहाँ पे जाके मैं अटक गई एकदम से कि मैं कैसे करूँ and like I said that I refer to the last 3 years papers तो मुझे थोड़ा idea आया that ये इस तरीके से लिखा जाता है but I was not very there was no guidance for me कि आपको this is how the process is followed and since it was the first year after the MOU जहाँ पे capstone 1 capstone 2 नहीं था तो कोई भी मेरे लिए guidance के लिए नहीं था वहाँ पे
true
तो मैंने क्या किया on I think if I remember it correctly on 13th of August I called up the person again and I said that I want to join so but what I did was I joined it for the May 2020 attempt
okay
so I told them that I will be joining for the May 2020 attempt but I will be giving the attempt in September 2019
okay
so उन्होंने मुझे 2019 के लिए जितना भी वो सपोर्ट कर सकते थे उन्होंने मुझे पूरा सपोर्ट दिया दे गेव मी ऑल द केसेस दे पास्ड ऑन टू मी ऑल द रिसोर्सेज दैट दे हैड एंड ड्यूरिंग फ्रॉम 13th ऑफ ऑगस्ट टिल द डेट ऑफ माय एग्जाम्स आई डिड ओनली दैट आई ओनली सॉल्वड केसेस आई डिड नथिंग एल्स
एंड देन फिर ये आपको ट्यूशन जो भी एक्स्ट्रा हेल्प थी इंडिया में ही मिल गई या कनाडा में लेना पड़ा
सो दैट वाज वर्चुअल
Oh, that was virtual. Okay, yes. Okay. So it's like जैसे US CPA में हम course material खरीदते हैं and then we can.
हाँ, you can say. So basically there are only two or three that I found while I was researching. So there was PASS, there was Prep Formula, and there was Densmore.
Okay.
These so are the three institutions that I found.
Okay. Which one did you go for?
I went for PASS. Also.
Nice.
So my experience with them was very good. I would just like to mention that I had actually researched about all the institutions before joining PASS. Their cost was a little higher than the other ones, but my reviews were a little better for them. So if anybody wants to join, I will suggest that they do their own research before going for any of the classes.
Of course. No, for sure. You know, anybody who's doing this, because this is a big investment, so you want to be sure that you know, you're investing according to your choice and not according to what someone else is saying about it.
Exactly.
Okay. And so do you know if this PASS or any of these study materials, do you know if there's like a timeline, like when we go for CPA, I remember back in the days when I did it, Becker's had a timeline of 18 months, Wiley's like was for life. So is there any timeline ki aap iske baad your course expire ho jayega, you won't be able to access the course, anything like that?
With the classes?
Yeah.
जहां तक मुझे पता है जितना मैंने उनसे बात किया है सो बेसिकली जैसे मैंने आपको बताया कि मैंने उनके साथ में मई 2020 के लिए रजिस्टर किया था बट उन्होंने मुझे पूरा सपोर्ट दिया सितंबर 2019 तक का बट मेरी जितनी उनसे बात हुई थी सो बेसिकली जब तक उनका कोई भी स्टूडेंट क्लियर नहीं कर जाता है एग्जाम तब तक एटलीस्ट वो आपको टेक्निकल सपोर्ट तो देते ही है अबाउट जो भी अपडेट्स आते हैं टेक्निकल मटेरियल में या फिर वो सब जो भी आते हैं वो सब आपको वो सपोर्ट देते हैं टिल द टाइम यू क्लियर So this is one thing and this is for all the classes. ये मैंने जितने भी लोगों से बात की ये सब चीजों का review था कि वो there is no problem in the support that they give is what my experience has been and whatever reviews that I have got till now.
Okay. And just one more question. If somebody has adequate amount of time, do you think the materials that you get from CPA Ontario itself, do you think that's enough to sail you through?
Just my experience, my experience along with the CPA Ontario material was absolutely amazing because like I said, the material is very easy to understand and anybody who reads it will be able to understand it very clearly, very, very clearly. The material is very nice. And secondly, the most important thing over here is that the exams are open book exams.
Oh,
Okay. So the thing is that you can refer to particular things while you are writing the exam. So आपको exam के time पे you have a reference. लेकिन वो reference use करने के लिए आपको पता होना चाहिए कि वो website पे वो चीज कहाँ पे है.
कहाँ है. Right.
Exactly. Right. तो वो जो वो जब मैंने उसी material से पढ़ा तो I knew that this is where I have to find things. Of course there is a search panel where you can search for, but मेरा उसके साथ में आई न्यू द थिंग्स दैट मुझे यहाँ पे नेविगेट करना है तो वो नेविगेशन मेरे लिए बहुत इजी हो गया
ओके एंड देन हाउ लॉन्ग डज इट टेक फॉर द रिजल्ट टू कम आउट इज इट लाइक ये सितंबर इनटेक का रिजल्ट कब तक आता है या मई एग्जाम्स होते कितने बार हैं साल में और रिजल्ट्स कब आते हैं
राइट सो अप टू 2019 सीपीए का सीपी खाली एक ही बार होता था साल में दैट इज सेप्टेम्बर
ओके
In May 2020, उनका एक पायलट प्रोजेक्ट था जहां पे वो लोग टू टाइम्स अ ईयर सीपी ट्राई करने वाले थे सो इट वॉज सपोज टू टेक यस सो इट वॉज सपोज टू टेक प्लेस इन May 2020 बट ड्यू टू कोविड कैंसिल हो गया वो सो दैट इज वाई आई वॉज प्रेपरिंग फॉर May 2020 एग्जाम बिकॉज आई वॉज श्योर दैट आई वॉज नॉट गोइंग टू क्लियर इन September 2019 या सो this was the first time that they were trying to, you know, see whether two times a year works out or not. But let's see if next year again they come out with the same thing or not.
Okay.
So that is two times a year.
And how long does it take for the results to come out?
Okay. So my results were supposed to come out, I think on 29th of November 2019.
Okay.
But since what happened was during my attempt, unka jo software tha, उन्होंने सॉफ्टवेयर चेंज किया था तो वो फर्स्ट ईयर था सॉफ्टवेयर का
ओके
सो देयर वर अ लॉट ऑफ टेक्निकल ग्लिचेस मेरे ड्यूरिंग द सितंबर 2019 अटेम्प्ट
ओके
सो बिकॉज ऑफ दैट दे टुक एक्स्ट्रा मेजर्स यू नो सो दैट पीपल हु हैड टू फेस दोस डिफिकल्टीज डू नॉट यू नो द रिजल्ट्स आर नॉट बायस्ड बेसिकली सो बिकॉज ऑफ दैट द रिजल्ट्स वर पोस्टपोन्ड And the results came on 7th of January, I think.
Okay. So 7th January.
Yeah. But usually the results come in November end.
Okay. Are the exams difficult? Like, did you feel that the studying piece was very difficult? And coming from an Indian CA background, did you feel that these exams were really difficult for us to do?
Basically, this question is very, very subjective because ye mujhe bahut logon ne pucha hai, but I will say that this question is extremely subjective for two reasons. Number one, that har ek insaan ka technical knowledge bahut differ karta hai. So, number one, that. And number two, a lot depends upon your communication skills over here because it is all about case writing. तो अगर आपकी टेक्निकल नॉलेज भी बहुत अच्छी हुई एंड अगर आपको केस लिखना नहीं आया इट विल बी अ वेरी बिग प्रॉब्लम फॉर यू. सो बट कंसिडरिंग इंडियन सीएस हमने ऑलरेडी इतना देखा है, इंडियन सीए में हमने इतनी पढ़ाई की है, हमने इतना ऑलरेडी वी हैव बिकम सो स्ट्रॉन्ग दैट टेक्निकली आई विल से दैट इट इज नॉट वेरी डिफिकल्ट. द मोर डिफिकल्ट पार्ट इज केस राइटिंग एंड even that is not difficult, it requires a lot of practice is what I will say.
Okay.
Yahan pe more than difficult what is required is practice, that aap bahut sare cases likho because ek case jo aapko shuru mein ek case jo 45 minutes lena chahiye wo aap 3 ghante tak likhte rahenge. It is as difficult as that, so you have to keep practicing a lot.
So you keep writing those cases and keep
yes you have to keep typing those cases. You have to, so that becomes very difficult because hame wo cheez ki bilkul bhi aadat nahi hai. So wo aadat lana is the more difficult part jo maine face kiya ki wo typing ki aadat lana. Rozana at least ek case likhna aur case likhne ke baad usko debrief karna. Only writing is not going to solve your problems.
Right. Yeah, agreed. One more question. Can you write it from outside Canada or do you write is the exam available only in Canada?
So for CFE, you have to be physically present in Canada to write the exam. You cannot write it as of now. You cannot write it from anywhere else.
And so a lot of people have this question about letter of good standing. I've only heard the term because everyone talks about letter of good standing.
I was actually expecting that question because bahut logon ne mujhse bhi ye pucha hai. So that is one of the registration requirements, which is letter of good, certificate of good standing from ICAI. And I don't know why there is such a big confusion because again, agar aap ICAI ki website pe jayenge, to उन्होंने भी बहुत ही सिंपली लिखा है what is the process that you need to follow. And मैंने letter of good standing के लिए online apply किया था. There are two processes. Number one, you can apply online. Number two, you can apply offline as well. I had directly applied it for online because it was a easier way. Okay. And within 14 days, exactly on the 14th day, I received my letter of good standing from ICAI.
It was a very simple process.
It was a very simple process. The only thing that I had to do was follow up with them a lot of times.
Okay, which is fine. I mean,
it is fine.
When I applied for my my CPA transcripts for my CA for CPA, it was a very seamless process. Applied, paid them money, they sent it. And of course, I had to follow up a couple of times, but that's it. But I've heard getting a letter of good standing is like some big deal, it's very difficult or something.
No, it's not at all difficult because even on the ICAI website, they have clearly mentioned how you have to go. You just have to fill a form, submit the form and follow up with them. I got the letter within 2 weeks. So for me, it was no problem.
Okay, perfect. And I think, that pretty much covers most of the questions, Joki. Hopefully people who want to write CFE have these are the questions that I would have had if I were writing CFE.
Absolutely.
So guys, I'm adding Nimisha's LinkedIn link below. If there's anything in specific that you want to know, please do your own research a little bit. That's what we always encourage. We're all professionals, so let's go do a little bit of research. If again you have some doubts left, her LinkedIn link is associated, it's in the description box, you can look at it. Reach out to her if you have any questions. And apart from that, I know Nimisha and I are wishing you all the very best. If you're considering,
all the best, guys.
If you're writing CPA Canada, all the very best. Just work hard. It's probably going to happen very soon. And thank you so much, Nimisha. Wish you all the very best with your journey ahead. I cannot wait to see what all you do with the CPA Canada.
Thank you so much, Nidhi. Thank you for having me here. Thank you.
This is great. Thanks. Bye.
Bye.